team just warming up. And after five played, they won five. And with a goal average of 162.5%. So 128 against, but 208 goals for. And they headed the list. Top of the table, Jenna Bowman and her sister Kyla are obviously going to be crucial. Kyla's not feeling so well at the moment, I've just heard, so she might be replaced. We've also got an injury or a problem with Sarah Montgomery as well, so she's not on that list, but it will be very much dependent on whether or not that great attack, Tiata Baldwin, the tall, tall girl, and Lua Rikis, the GS and GA, can actually break through, because the Northern Ireland defense is the meanest in the tournament so far. Very, very impressive. 157 points conceded in the tournament, which is by far the best. There are the substitutions, but I have to say, Sarah Montgomery is not even ready to come on board. So there's only a GA and a GS, and we might be in for a surprise in a while to see who is going to come up inside that circle for attack for Northern Ireland. They did actually beat the Papua New Guinea team by 47-35. That was yesterday. But that said, the GS, the big girl there in the center, is Tiata Baldwin. She wasn't playing in that match, so that would have made a big difference, I'm sure. Northern Ireland were winners in 2009, the last time they came here to Singapore. They're out to keep that record going. They're certainly very, very impressive. When they get through the phases from defence into attack, they do it very quickly. Julie Kimber has done a great job as the coach. And there, we've got the announcements of the teams. And I'll just let the stadium announcer make those introductions before I introduce my co-commentator.
Join the network for us.
there are our umpires for this one, Tara Warner and Joan Yanni. Yanni, of course, on the right there. And this will be the final match of the 2015 series of the Mission Foods Nations Cup. I've got with me Perlin Chan, who was a former captain back in 2005, 2007, and part of the Singapore team that was very successful, not only in this Nations Cup, it celebrates 10 years now, but of course the Asian trophy as well. And we're going to get underway, Perlin. How do you see this?
I think we've got a match on our hands. Both teams have played really well all week, and Northern Ireland just shows how they got into the finals, really.
Really, really impressive. They beat Papua New Guinea 35-47. Northern Ireland scored against it, but they didn't have Tiata Baldwin. And we'll see her in action in just a couple of moments. She's absolutely towering, but that's really, really good play by the captain and goalkeeper, Gemma Gibney. She, one of the great features of the Northern Irish play. And there's, well, I've got a feeling that was a foot out, was it?
Yeah, I think she was jumping into court from outside to receive the ball, and you can't do that.
Okay. Well, the feature has certainly been their very impressive intercept play. And there's O'Hanlon with another first intercept, which gives them a very, very good opportunity. It's one love at the moment, and now the two sisters, the Bowman sisters, are there. Kyla's there, but Jenna has got the highest percentage, in fact, just. That is a 70.39%, 152 attempts over 107. But that ball has gone out, and that will be now Papua New Guinea. Long ball out, but again, lots and lots of space there. There's the big ball, and that's, you can see, that's what their tactic will be. It's a dangerous one. The left-handed Lua Rikis tries to find her ball shooter, and it wasn't very successful. Northern Ireland will definitely be the favourites for this.
Yeah, well, you know, you have a tall, big shooter in the circle. It's easy to find, but it's also about pinpoint accuracy. It's not just like throw the ball anywhere and someone will get it.
Well, Jenna Bowman missed that opportunity. It was right at her and snatched at it. There were a few nerves here in the opening stages. Papua New Guinea certainly have been impressive. They've left things to the last minute on odd occasions through matches, but they beat Singapore 44-43 in the opening match. That was an absolute cracker. Very exciting. And they then smashed Chinese Taipei 60-39, and then had a real close encounter with Botswana. It was 46-44 before coming 37-36 over the Singapore Invitational. So has been close, has been tight. Second point on the board for Northern Ireland, and the two Bowmans have now scored. I heard, talking to the coach earlier, that was Julie Kimber, and she did tell me that Sarah Montgomery had problems, so she's not going to appear. She was struggling a little bit, and she's been very successful around the circle. Now, Jenna Bowman also is having problems with her fitness and health at the moment, so we might see somebody coming into the circle for Northern Ireland that's not played there before. We'll see.
I will keep a lookout for that. But in the meantime, I mean, Northern Ireland's doing really well. The defense has been a highlight all week, and they have started off really well in this game.
Indeed, and there's Jenna Bowman with her second point, and Northern Ireland's third. Again, it just shows Northern Ireland really tightening up in defence. And again, it's a good piece of play. Excellent work. Gibney is right on it. I love her style. There she is, the goalkeeper. And O'Hanlon is coming up to get the ball again. And it's a long ball through to Drayne, over to Jenna. And, whoa, just a foot out. Drayne is a very, very good wing attack, I tell you. She absolutely flies around the court. O'Hanlon again looking for the opportunity to regain possession. And a little bit of contact there. The wing defender will come back. And that is Niamh Cooper, the vice captain. They are closing her out, aren't they? It's really interesting the way the GD and the GK are working on Tiata Baldwin, the goal shooter. This is Lua Rikis. You told me you've actually played against her a few times as well, Lua.
Yeah, PNG have been in Singapore on several occasions. The first time in 2004. So to see Lua still playing, it's just amazing.
Well, she's 33 years old, and Winnie Mavara, the centre, is 37 and still working hard. Here's Kyla. That's for four. 4-1. 5 minutes gone in the first quarter. We're in the final match of the Mission Foods Nations Cup 2015 in Singapore. The OCBC arena full of good atmosphere. There's a, considering the hosts are not involved here, there's a lot of good shouting. Again, you like the way that the technique of the goalkeeper is right there. Gemma Gibney trying to hold her position up against Tiata Baldwin. Good. Okay, the bounce pass is no good, but Ireland will keep, Northern Ireland will keep possession. Drayne is coming there for the ball, picks it up, and O'Hanlon helps her out. Away. And that was just a step out, so that will be Northern Ireland's ball underneath the net.
Papua New Guinea really needs to tighten up on the defense, because the Northern Irish girls are just, you know, having a field day. They just go anywhere they want and pass any pass they choose. So it's really about tightening up and making it difficult for the Northern Ireland team.
The closing down is very, very important. And just look at that, two on one at the transverse line, the attack line. It forces them to use options in the past that are not as good. There you go. And that's, I must say, Tiata Baldwin has not had a good start to this match. She's messed up on a couple of occasions. It's 5-2 with Northern Ireland in possession.
What's interesting about Tiata Baldwin's play is she's not your typical tall goal shooter. She moves quite a bit, so that's interesting. And she just kind of needs to time off Lua and just balance the thing so you don't get two shooters out at the same time.
Northern Ireland again, some very quick interaction here. O'Hanlon calling for it, but it's going to be Kyla again. Well, maybe she was suffering from a bit of sickness, but I tell you what, as long as she keeps scoring, she won't be in any mood to give up her position. They don't have another fully fledged attacker or goal shooter. And that's another play. O'Hanlon passes it to Kyla. Drayne puts it over the top, and that's out of play. It will be PNG 2-6 at the moment. And again, there's a lot of O'Hanlon arms going out here. That's better. Oh, the stepping there by the centre, Winnie Mavara.
Yeah, that's been happening a lot through the weeks in all the teams. Just little stepping, creeping into the game.
Well, I tell you, the Australian umpires have been very strict on it, so they will learn. Kyla plays it back to Drayne. Kyla's in position again, turns nicely, takes her position and misses that one, but Jenna puts it out, and that will be another Kyla play. Northern Ireland have got it there. O'Hanlon finds it immediately back into the danger zone, and it's in the net for 7-2. Northern Ireland, a great start this.
Yeah, the Northern Ireland team has started with a lot of intensity, especially on the defense end. They really mean business, John.
They do, and what impresses me, they're staying within the rules as well. They are staying. Oh, there was a little bit of stepping there against Gibney. That's amazing. Doesn't normally make that kind of error, but she intercepted beautifully. I really like the idea. Sorry, Philip, but I really like the idea that they will. That's short. And that's the advantage of being a bit tall.
A bit tall. Yeah.
But they're keeping their distance and not committing the fouls, which has littered the others. Oh, well, Kyla was a little bit lucky to keep in there. Well, in fact, it's now against the play. Do you know what that was? Was that a rebound?
I suspect that's probably offside. So offside. The centre has fallen into the goal circle. And only the goal shooter, goal attack, goalkeeper, yeah, and goal defense are allowed in there.
That's Northern Ireland's ball, and again Gibney does a brilliant job keeping Tiata Baldwin stretching for that one. 7-3 Northern Ireland. Wing defence for Northern Ireland is Niamh Cooper, vice captain. You know, the Toner has also put in a really good shift throughout the week. Really impressed with her. She's got a heavily bandaged left shoulder, but there's the Northern Irish supporters. They've had a good week. Really enjoyed themselves. Last time they came here was 6 years ago, so, and they were champions then. Oh, and then,
another stuffing.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it? And that was a game. Winnie Mavara. Or was it? Oh, it's wing attack. Jacklyn Lahari actually committed the problem there. Drayne is in good shape. Good running again. And look at O'Hanlon in position. A little tickle over the top. And I have to say, Kilala Owen is not going to find this easy. She has to stand beside a free throw here. And it's in from Kyla once more for a 9-3 lead. O'Hanlon moves it away, and it's a long ball again. That's really good play. Direct and efficient, and it's 10-3.
Papua New Guinea, sorry, John. Papua New Guinea really needs to regroup. You know, they're 10-3 down. It's really just doing simple things well. You know, putting some hands over, just slowing up the ball a little.
I think the fact that they lost fairly heavily yesterday, despite the fact that Baldwin was not involved, it just means that they're feeling under pressure from the start. They know they've got to do something a little bit special. Northern Ireland are certainly after that. You know, they had a poor first quarter last night, but they've certainly not repeated that this time round. They came back into it significantly in the second and third quarters. So watch out, Papua New Guinea, I would say, because the efficiency of passing is certainly very impressive. There you go, it's over the top. The lob pass is good. Jenna will be there, makes it easily. It's 11-4. It's all looking very simple for Northern Ireland.
It is. And they're hustling every single ball. I mean, it's only the first quarter. You know, we've just played 12 minutes, and they mean business. They're ready to get every single ball.
Oh, and another error, and again under pressure. But Gemma Gibney, I can tell you now, she is absolutely determined. She is part of the team that actually won in 2009. I think one of the only ones here, if I'm not mistaken, from that original team. But they do struggle to get together, you know. They don't practice a huge amount. They're spread over all of Northern Ireland. There's a couple. Oh, can't touch that. Oh, allowed it to go on. That's interesting.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe they thought the opponent touched it. Anyway, it doesn't matter. The umpires didn't blow. Oy. Okay.
That was a good pass, I see.
It was a good pass. It was either the worst shot or the best pass.
The best pass.
Oh, they're finding it too easy, I tell you. Jenna's right there again. She's a long way out, but her sister Kyla's right there. Has that been given against the play? It has.
Oh, that was strange.
That is strange. Well,
so it's possession by goal defence.
Okay, well, that was Joan Yanni making herself very clear. Although there was a bit of disappointment, you could tell from Kyla.
Another stop, John. Yeah.
12-4, and a turnover once again. O'Hanlon again has been superb. Look at her running around the outside, and she will come over the top again for Kyla. Well, it doesn't matter whether you are just a bit upset about one decision. You've got to keep the concentration, and that's exactly what she did. Look at that for an intercept. Oh, beautiful work. Toner again, and oh, you can't believe that.
They can do no wrong.
Amazing play from outside the court by Toner. Moves it in, and off balance, Kyla Bowman puts it into the net, and I have to say, another one there. It's all going according to plan for Northern Ireland with less than 1 minute left in the first quarter. They are absolutely flying at the moment. 15 points to find. Another error, 3 seconds there, holding the ball, not allowed to do that. And I can tell you, when this comes back in from Gibney, they will definitely move this up for a score. 41 seconds is a lot of time. Oh, Hanlon puts it over. No problem here for Kyla. Well, what did I say? Second time round. There's still a lot of opportunity here. The score is short again. Oh, my goodness. But one more chance for a game. Too close contact. 18 seconds. Still the ball. The scoreboard is running. And there, Jenna makes it. Comes back now. 12 seconds. Still a chance. Here we go. Where's that Papua New Guinea defence? It's all over the place at the moment. Jenna comes. O'Hanlon finds space. 1 second, it's out, and it's finished. The end of the first quarter. And really, you'd be very greedy if you wanted to have one more point from that position. I tell you what, that is a very, very impressive first quarter for Northern Ireland. They're in total control. And I can think that Papua New Guinea will really, really have to change their tactics completely to get back into this. 16-4 is an annihilation at the quarter.
It almost looks like it, but it's just a good chance to regroup. You know, quarter time, start fresh, pretend the first quarter didn't happen, and then just keep going again.
I've got a feeling it was 11-4 in favour of Papua New Guinea last night, if my memory serves me correct. We've got the replays here. It'll all be Northern Ireland, that's for sure. Now for that first quarter, 16-4, and that's extraordinary. The goal percentage is in Papua New Guinea's favour, but they didn't get many chances because the extraordinary turnovers, 11 there against Papua New Guinea, and you have to say that the speed of transition from defence into attack was really, really impressive, and it blew Papua New Guinea away.
Yeah, Northern Ireland were just so quick, you know, they get out of their goal circle really quickly. So, you know, Papua New Guinea just needs to sort of hold up the ball a little bit more just to give the defenders time.
Right, well, just to give you a little more background, the Bowman sisters actually hail from a little village, Magarafelt, in Northern Ireland. In fact, an even smaller village, apparently, is Gemma Gibney's Loppin Island. It sounds like something out of a movie, doesn't it? A kid's movie, Loughlin Island.
Sounds
the goalkeeper.
Beautiful, though.
It does. Lisburn is Michelle Drayne's home. Fionnuala Toner comes from Belfast, and Caroline O'Hanlon from Newry. So they're spread around all over Northern Ireland. They get together occasionally in Belfast for their training. And I have to say, considering that they have spread around the world, and they're not professionals, of course. That's a lovely take, but unlucky there from Toner. You just can't keep a good girl down, can you?
No, you can't, and they're just all over the place.
She's got a really bad shoulder injury, but she refuses to sit on the bench, I can tell you. Here's a chance, hooray! We've got now first points of the second quarter in favor of Papua New Guinea, 5-16. Drayne almost holds on, nicely picked up again. And we've got a few Papua New Guinea changes. We'll tell you about them in just a while. Jenna makes one. It's 17-5. We've got goal defender Jeperth Tulapi comes in now for Papua New Guinea. And something's got to be done. Okay, well done once more. Tiata Baldwin takes it from... This is what they've been doing in previous matches. Very quickly.
Well, at least that was a better start than the first quarter.
Definitely. Long ball up, and Jenna misses. It comes to Kilala Owen now, the goalkeeper for Papua New Guinea. She plays it forward to Mavara, and another error here, but it will stay with PNG. They've actually paid their way here, you know, the flights, the Northern Irish girls. So the amount of support they can expect from the Federation Association is fairly limited. Although I know that there is support when it comes to major international tournaments like this. They have to find their own money.
Yeah, I think that's the case for a lot of netball associations around the world. And it probably tells you how passionate the girls are, you know.
Absolutely.
It's like, we'll pay our way, we'll get there, just to play some good netball.
They've had a good week, of course. And it's that extraordinary player, the goal defender, Fionnuala Toner, who comes again and fights for possession. In defence, again. Cooper, and well, this is a much better opportunity for PNG. Over the top again, and too easy. Oh, surely she should have got that first time. Decided to go for it, and yeah, really, really smooth action over the top of Kilala Owen and into the net for an 18-8. Oh, that is. Some other play going on. I see Joan Yanni's called it from
yeah, that's bad luck for Caroline O'Hara.
Yeah.
Because that was good intercept, I thought.
It was. Wing attack again is Jacklyn Lahari, and once again it is Baldwin, Tiata Baldwin, that is right there on the money.
Much better passing into the circle to Tiata Baldwin by PNG.
Yeah, they have found her a lot easier in this second quarter, but right, well, that will be PNG's, and the fight back here. It was 16-4 in the first. It's 5-2 in the second in favor of PNG right at this moment. Oh, another bit of stepping. Disaster. O'Hanlon, and then over. Nice play again. She will put them in from any distance. Oh, Kyla. We've got a Bowman, two times Bowman at the Northern Ireland game. We've got a Baldwin at the PNG side, and they'll be looking for her again. Well, there she is, and makes it.
Yeah. Good strong take by Tiata Baldwin.
It was a good pass from Lua Rikis, though, knew where she was. And here we go, Drayne puts it out wide, and Drayne will pick it up again. A little lucky. Over the top, and that's good work this time from Kyla. Outside, off the rim, and away. And again, PNG beginning to pick up a little bit. There's been a couple of substitutions here. The wing defender is Shanna Dringo. In again for 11. This is a good fight back. 7-3 in the quarter, and they've got possession as well. PNG fighting. Oh, and that was
a breaking, yeah.
A breaking early from that zone that they're not allowed into. From the centre pass. Toner bounce passes it to Drayne. Jenna's there, looking for the hip away, and does well. And is in again for 20. 20 points to 11. O'Hanlon is right in the middle. Coming up in support is a very impressive Niamh Cooper. And O'Hanlon again puts it over the top to Jenna, who will happily wait for it. And a little bit of hipping there.
So this is much better play.
Yep.
Much better defense by PNG. You know, they're holding up the ball. You're just letting Northern Ireland put in a few more passes and giving yourself a chance to intercept.
Well, they've picked up 2 points over the situation after the first quarter. So, well, Gibney does well, but then it all comes back again. And Baldwin again, bounce passes. Well, Rikis is actually a very, very good shooter, but we haven't seen much of it. That's out, and it will be. Well, Gibney does well to avoid touching that right at the death as that ball went out over the baseline. Cooper looking for support. A bit too close contact.
So PNG is putting on the zone in the midcourt.
Yeah.
Just to confuse the space, make it a little harder, hold up the ball a little longer.
Putting on the pressure. In basketball, they call it a court press. Is that what it is? Is it a full court press?
I'm not great with basketball.
Okay.
But you're probably right.
Okay, well, the midcourt is pressing all the time against the defenders trying to break out. There we go again. Jenna from a little distance, but no, Kyla will take that. Well, it comes back again, so a bit closer. Kyla is still, they work well, don't they?
They do.
The girls from Margarafelt. If you heard us say that, you can say a big cheer for that town in Northern Ireland. And there's another bit of traveling, a bit of stepping. It's going to be played back again because Toner is going to, well, again, it's the wrong player. She didn't commit the foul.
So they're just advancing the ball because, yep, you know, the penalty hasn't, yep, been taken correctly.
Yep. Again, nice hands, good passing. O'Hanlon again. Drayne plays it on over the top. It's easy. Jenna's right there. But Kyla picks it up and gets the second chance. This for 24. It's in.
Good rebound in between the sisters.
Yeah. The rebound sisters. Sounds like a good group.
I wonder what music they do.
That was a reverse pass that was no good from Kyla. Over the top, and that's no good either. Wow, goal attack. You don't want that. Lua Rikis, she knows how important it is to put it really up in the air. This is good from Drayne. And the bounce pass, but it wasn't needed because of the contact. Wow, too easy. And, well, Jenna will try, but that's nicely picked up by the goal defense, Susan Wellington. Mavara plays it in. Okay, that's much better. Okay, Gibney goes over the top. She'll stand by the side and watch this go in. Oop, just
about.
12, 24. It's 8-all in the second quarter. 12, 24 altogether. So it's a good first quarter for Northern Ireland. They will have a chance to level up with this possession from the half. Trey moves it down again to Cooper. O'Hanlon makes herself available, and it's over the top. It's a beauty. Lovely, lovely lob pass, and, well, she'll get another chance there. Okay, that's 25. Just a little under 5.5 minutes left in the half. Northern Ireland in the finals, and it will be Northern Ireland's ball.
Yeah, it was contact.
Yeah.
Yes, contact.
Thank you. Contact of the still in play, but picked up nicely by the wing attack. That was good from Jacklyn Lahari. Well, it's not as exciting as the third, fourth place match, that's for sure. It's far too easy at the moment for Northern Ireland. That will be a PNG ball at the goal line. Making a sandwich of Baldwin.
Another clever play by Lua Rikis. This is the second time today that we've seen the pole pass, I call that.
The pole pass.
Pass to the pole and get it back yourself.
There we go. Rikis has got it. Just half a step. There we go. That's in. That's for 14. 14-25. It's 10-9 to Papua New Guinea in the quarter. But this will level it up. This will be 10-all. Jenna asking, where should I go, miss? It's 26-14. Papua New Guinea have just been outsmarted, particularly in the counter-attacking area. was struggling a little bit, and that is another high pass, but Gibney this time is caught, and Rikis will take it. Rikis slots it home for 15-26, and again, it's a really much more even Steven quarter this one. Papua New Guinea finding space and opportunity and converting a lot more.
Yeah, Papua New Guinea would probably hope that this was the first quarter instead of the horror start that they had. You know, it would have been so much closer.
Leveled up in the quarter though at 11-all, but at 27-15, it's all very much now with just a bit over 3 minutes left in the half. It's Northern Ireland looking very, very solid. Almost a 3 second error, and it will be coming into the circle. And again, hands were in the wrong place. Lua Rikis a little bit to the side, and around the rim and down.
Rosen.
Yep. Oh, Hanlon. Cooper now from the center. Nice one-handed pass to Drayne. Good. A little bit of juggling there by Kyla, but she will make this. And she does. It's 28-16. 12-all in the quarter. 28-16 in the match. Claiming it there was O'Hanlon, but she's not giving it. Susan Wellington comes up from whole position to the limit of her potential for the transverse line. And once again, she's right on the line. Rikis takes the high ball and makes it there. Good work. 17-28.
That was a nice block by Rikis, you know, indicating where she wants the ball.
It was.
It was a perfect pass.
It was. Tiata Baldwin wandering a little bit and making good play. O'Hanlon again plays it in. Oh, and there's some more stepping going on. What's happening?
You almost wonder if the teams will, you know, just walk up to the umpire and just sort of seek clarifications, because it has happened quite a bit.
It has. It's the Aussie way, you know. Oh, I love it. Another good, good, solid pass. This is where they have undone the opposition hitherto. They've got possession again with a little over 1 minute left in the half. It's another big pass, another big play, easy down, and it's in. 19-28. O'Hanlon with 1 minute left finds now Jenna. Oh my goodness, what's happened there? Goodness me. Swap places there with that one. Oh, and it's another, a lucky recovery, I have to say. Kyla's there. Kyla makes it. 40 seconds left. PNG have the ball at the halfway line. There's plenty of time. Oh, and it comes back to a lucky break here for Northern Ireland. Cooper has got a bounce pass to O'Hanlon. Cooper, Fionnuala Toner is in support as well as Drayne. There's a long ball to O'Hanlon. Jenna's there, Kyla's there, coming in on it, and it's a beauty. 12 seconds left, 30 points to 19. One more chance, it's got to be quick, it's over the top, it's too far. And that is the end of the first half then. And Northern Ireland have taken it 30 points to 19. But the great thing is, Pearline, I'm sure, will have a quote, some comments on the fact that PNG have come back and have won that particular quarter by 1 point. It's been good.
It has been, you know, PNG really came back strongly after that first quarter horror start, but then that's just what you have to do, regroup, refocus, and start again.
So we will be getting some highlights of that quarter in just a couple of moments, but the crowd, a couple of moments to relax. Here we go. particular piece of play with O'Hanlon to Bowman, to Kyla Bowman was fantastic and totally typical. I'm not sure I believe these percentages, the goal percentage. Papua New Guinea, 95%, surely they'd be in the lead if that was the case.
Yeah, but unfortunately, look at the number of attempts that Northern Ireland has. It's almost twice as many as PNG.
Well, that is certainly been standard today. In fact, before this match, they were 65% average. So maybe that is the way. It's a different way of playing the game, that's for sure. Accuracy, we've always been told, is the way to go. But, well, we'll see whether or not the next half will bring back or bring a revolution for PNG. At the moment, Northern Ireland in total control. We'll take a little break and then join us again in a while. So we have now the second half just about to restart. Here we go. And the match, well, it's been a fascinating one. Northern Ireland were totally in control in the first quarter. They've given up a little bit of momentum in the second quarter with PNG coming back strongly. And Tiata Baldwin in particular, the goal shooter, having a lot more of her own. But there they go, Papua New Guinea from right to left on the screen, and that's really good defensive work, very nicely played by Toner, and a quick play forward it goes, Jenna Bowman's on it and makes it for 31-19. Of course, with O'Hanlon restarting the play on the centre pass. Oi, 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 your sisters, you're supposed to know what's happening.
It's just a small, small miscommunication there, yep. Small one.
And that's even worse, I think, that ball. Okay, the turnovers running they show at the moment. But 31-19, we are in the final. That's another bad pass. We are in the final, the last match of the 2015 championship. And that was a really good shot again from, oh my goodness, and breaking too early.
Yeah, that was totally unnecessary.
The breakout, no good. 11 points of difference at the moment. Toner's got the ball, moves it to Drayne. Over the top. And, well, it will be a game. And Kyla leaves it for Jenna now, who's so close. Whoops, and another opportunity. Stand by my side. It's easy, it's 32. And then again, really working well, Toner O'Hanlon is right on it. And I must say, Joan Yanni, she's quite strict on action right under the basket. And Jenna gets one more crack. It's really tough for Kilala Owen. So Kyla picks it up off the rebound. And again it goes off, but it will be now a PNG ball from the goal line. It's all a little bit scrappy this opening third quarter.
It is. And so that's jumping out from outside the court again.
Drayne bounces it to Kyla, who's found Hanlon on the far side. And again, Kyla's there. She will make this. It's a beauty. 33-20. And now let's see if we can get some patterns settling here. Passage of play needs to, well, yeah, that's a beauty. Wow, now
we've wonderful shot.
Yeah, Lua Rikis, the captain. She has got a really, really good record. Was that three? No, it's
still. That was a little contact, I think.
Yeah. Kyla is short. Easily picked up. But, oh, goodness me. A little bit lucky there for Northern Ireland to pick this one up. Kyla's once there and short once again off the near side of the rim to her. Yeah, some good passing, lovely eyes. Oh, a little bit lucky for Gemma Gibney, and the Baldwin wants it to come to their team. It didn't happen. Oh, that's nice.
This is a quick transition that Northern Ireland has done all week, and it's just beautiful to watch.
Very interesting, very impressive. They're moving into space well, that's the thing. Look at there, O'Hanlon, easy again, and it's left to the, oh, where was the defender there? No defense, two marking against Jenna. Nobody thinking that Kyla was going to get it. That's better. Lua Rikis again. She's got that one. Rikis does well. O'Hanlon. Long ball. Jenna's right there. It's the quick attack, isn't it? Well, surely that was a little bit of a foul on the play. You can go over the top, but you can't actually touch the ball like that, can you? More fouls.
Yeah, a little bit of contact going on in the circle.
And another one. And it will be Jenna who will take it.
Third time lucky.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you do make your own luck because you're forcing them to make fouls, I guess. That was travelling, was it? Oh, no. Okay, it was a little bit of contact off the ball.
A little bit of holding the player.
35-22, 5-3 in this third quarter. And again, umpire's doing a good job here. Tara Warner, and up she goes. Baldwin will make this. She is a danger girl, but that first quarter performance by Northern Ireland has actually kept the crowd quiet because the gap is so, so big. Even now, 35-23. O'Hanlon plays it in. Drayne is there, and Jenna picks it up once again for the conversion. It's out.
Good rebound.
Yep. A little bit of a push by Kyla. Left for Kilala Owen. Susan Wellington is doing a good job there. There's Kilala Owen, there's Wellington, and now it's come up again for goal attack Rikis. Oh,
that's
Cooper.
Bad luck.
It was. Cooper's really quick on those. Very, very fast. Came through like an express train.
She did.
35-23, and a little lucky. They are struggling to find a place, but Rikis there comes through nicely. Makes it for 24. 5-5 in the third quarter. They've got the possession again from the centre pass. Yeah, they really are. They're moving much better now, Papua New Guinea. Baldwin is, there was a little foul on the edge of the circle. There we go. The centre, Mavara, will take it. Baldwin has it right there. K Gibney goes for a big jump, no good. Not much you can do about that. 35-25. Drayne puts it down, but wow, that's really great play from Owen. Beautiful play, gets the intercept and then moves it forward. PNG having a golden spell here at the moment. Gibney is giving it away.
This really makes, you know, the first quarter such a letdown, you know, because the gap was so big then, and then now they're so competitive. You almost wish that the first quarter didn't happen.
35-26, and they'll get it back again. PNG nibbling away at this lead. Baldwin looking for support on the inside. It didn't happen. Rikis had to go there. Now Baldwin is there. That's good into passing. Lovely triangles in the passes there.
Yeah, lovely play. You know, someone drives forward and someone pulls back and pick the right one.
Northern Ireland have got to wake up a little bit. They've slowed down. They slowed the pace. Drayne has got it on the left side. Now it's easy for Kyla, but she's again short. How many times? We might just get a substitution, you know. She was, I was told that she wasn't feeling great. And that is a good turnover, and it wouldn't take a lot. That's a foul by Drayne. Wouldn't take a lot. Maybe we will get a substitution. Coming in for goal attack, Kyla Bowman. 35-27 at the moment. Ooh, stepping there by Baldwin.
Yeah, it's always a letdown when it's an easy turnover.
That's really smooth. That is very smooth transition. Beautiful work. Owen goes up and it's short again. My goodness. And well, she wants a medical timeout now. She wants a medical timeout. And I tell you what, that is... Okay, she will get a look at the angle, but I think we might get... Ah, wouldn't be interesting. We might get a substitution now for Kyla Bowman.
We'll just keep a lookout on the bench to see who's warming up.
Yeah. It's a guessing game at the moment. I was warned by Julie Kimber that they might have to do this. With the score at 36-27, it's probably a good time to bring in another player for the goal attack. We will see.
But Northern Ireland is still doing really well. I mean, the transition out from their defending to third is still quite fast, and it, most of the passes have stuck, so it's just a little bit of putting the shots through the net.
Yeah. No, it's very solid. I mean, other than that first quarter, that was a totally dominant situation. There's O'Hanlon again. Let's have a look at it a little bit more. There's O'Hanlon with that long pass. Another really good shot from Kyla Bowman. She has been playing well.
And what I like about Carolyn O'Hanlon as center is she's so calm. You know, she looks like she has all the time in the world. She picks the really good decisions and the right players. So it's quite nice watching her play center.
The girl from Nerrie, she's 31 now. Don't know how many more seasons she's intending to play. She loves the sport like everybody in this game of netball. Oh, she's going to come back on court. Wow, isn't that interesting? Isn't that interesting?
So I guess she's just going to shake it off and grit her teeth.
Okay, so that left ankle's got a bandage around it anyway. It's centre pass, 27-36. And immediately Rikis comes up and passes it. Baldwin is right there, and is she short? Gets a second chance because she can.
Always important to get your own rebound.
Yeah. I tell you, there's a lot of aggression.
There is. I mean, considering both of them have won the Nations Cup once each, I'm sure they want to be the second team, sorry, because Singapore won it twice in 2006 and 2007.
That's right.
So both teams want to be the, you know, to win twice as well.
Drayne has got it on the edge of the circle. Jenna has to chase it. It won't make it. That's going to be PNG, and a lack of concentration there by Michelle Drayne. They really got to keep their concentration, accuracy here in Northern Ireland. Can't allow Papua New Guinea to come back into it anymore. They've got a 9-6 lead in this third quarter, which is significant. That's better from Gibney, and she was fouled, that hand over the top by Baldwin, and that is a good turnover. It needed it right there, to be quite honest. O'Hanlon again looking for outs. Ooh, okay, well, that will be Toner who will pick that up right there.
Contact by Shanna, yep. Dringo, wing defense for PNG.
O'Hanlon looking for out once again, and it's contact. Kyla puts it over to Jenna. Jenna Bowman, short again, how many more times? And the rebounds by the defenders, very, very solid. Well, last time, Gemma Gibney had to come to the rescue. I can tell you, if they're not successful next time, we could be seeing a substitution. Here we go, it's another long ball, and there, a little bit of contact from Baldwin this time. Drayne does well, a little lob pass again to O'Hanlon. And it will be Jenna, and together with Kyla, who've got that opportunity to score. Kyla's got the ball, makes it, 37.
Northern Ireland's defense has been really impressive. I mean, they give their shooters a lot of attempts, as we could see from the stats, you know, the quarter stats.
That's a nice pass. Oh, it's short. Gibney will do her best to get to it, but it won't happen. O'Hanlon again very quickly moves up. Drayne comes to the rescue. Jenna Bowen. Yeah, that's good. O'Hanlon once again feeds well. Oh dear. Had the chance, but Owen gets there. Long pass out to Mavara. Mavara comes forward, but that is a really bad pass. Picked up easily by Gibney. Toner puts it over the top to Drayne. Drayne is to Kyla. The Bowman sisters are right there, and there's a game short. How many more times? I can tell you, that will not go down well on the bench. There's been so many opportunities to score. They've wasted at least five or six, even in this quarter. That will be against Gibney, and swung around there.
Yeah, a little bit of hand-holding.
Yeah. That's in for 29. 30 now. 7 points the difference. I tell you what, that is not impossible to come back into this. Northern Ireland really do need to sharpen up there. Well, in fact, that's against the attacker. And that will be hugely disappointing. Do you think fitness plays a part after 5-6 days of, well, this is a sixth match, but 5 days of competition?
Yeah, it definitely does. I mean, it's almost consecutive games with just one rest day. And these matches are really hard on the body. So, you know, and we're at the tail end of the competition, so it takes a bit of a toll on the body.
This will be well appreciated then for Northern Ireland. They come down to 150 in this third quarter. They're losing it by 11-8, but overall they're 8 points in the lead, 38-30. Again, a bit of bounce passing, dribbling there, and Kyla will make this for sure, because she's missed a few on the low side. She's hit the early part of the rim, and she's learned from that. It's a great thing about feedback, isn't it? You know exactly how to alter, change your situation. And Northern Ireland closing down here.
Yes, and I think with technology, and you know, a lot of teams are using video analysis, and that usually helps with feedback as well.
It's 1 minute left, and another conversion by Baldwin underneath the net. Cooper and Toner have done well. And that's another super, super save from Owen. It really was needed. 44 seconds left. Three quarters. Oh, and that's a really poor, poor piece of play.
Yeah, definitely that's a shame.
Needed to move it forward, not sideways. But of course, again, that's good defending, of course. Gibney particularly was covering up. Toner and O'Hanlon working in harness there together, but it will be another ball from the sideline, and that is 17 seconds left. It's come now to Papua New Guinea. They've got to be quick with the big press from Northern Ireland, wanting to keep it there. 10 seconds, that's good. Good first touch. But, well, it's there, 4-3-2, and it's in. Good work there for 32. They're back within 7 points now at the end of the third quarter. Northern Ireland have given up 4 points in that quarter, 13-9 in favour of Papua New Guinea. And you have to say that they deserve that position. They were a lot more active, particularly in the defensive third, and their transition's much better. And of course, Baldwin has come into her own again, and Lua Rikis has given her good support. All in all, hey, this is not done and dusted yet.
No, it's totally different from when it first started. So PNG has really picked themselves up and have given all their all to chip away the deficit.
Enjoy the highlights of that third quarter. Goodness, 62 over 36. Goal percentage significantly still higher by Papua New Guinea. Baldwin and Rikis working well in harness. Rebounds, 8 as well. No wonder they won that quarter. That was very impressive. Obstruction, 15 over 3. What's all that about? Explain that to me.
It's a little bit about discipline, but then, you know, there's this fine line between getting into your opponent's face and being disciplined. So maybe that's something enough. Then all in all, I mean, just looking at the quarter scores, they're doing really well.
There you go, 16-4, destroyed after the first one. 14-15, the Papua New Guinea. They won the second just. They've won the third by significantly more. Hey, I tell you what, they should look at that and be really, really impressed, because it's all up from that time on. In fact, it was quite the opposite yesterday, when Northern Ireland absolutely were blown apart in the first quarter and then made improvements right the way through and then came away with a very significant 35-47 win, ultimately won by 12. But they lost. They were losing so heavily. I think it was 11-4 in the first quarter. So, well, all the play for still. 7 points the difference. Northern Ireland will be receiving the power play. Oh, and that's a Gibney special. That is a big, big bonus for Northern Ireland to turn the ball over so early in that quarter. It's a nice two-handed pass down to Toner from Drayne. Still in play. Woods has come on now at the centre. We can see Woods has come off the centre.
And O'Hallen has gone into that goal attack from centre.
That was the surprise that we were looking for.
Yes.
So there she is with her first shot, and it's a good one. Well done, Caroline O'Hanlon. She gets on the scoring board, her first score in the Nations Cup competition of 2015. I tell you what, she has been such an impressive player, though. You wouldn't rule against her, actually, picking up significantly more. That will be another chance for Northern Ireland to pick it up. So Kyla does go off and replaced by Carolyn O'Hanlon. Jenna Bowman is right there. O'Hanlon will take it. O'Hanlon. Well, misses that second one. A little bit further back, of course, but Woods does well. And the applause from the crowd tells her she's done well, because she's responsible for that point. 41-32. This gives certainly a lot more hope. Gibney, oh my goodness me. She's a tall girl. She's got to get down low when it's necessary, though. She's got a bad left knee. You can see the bandage on it, but no excuse for that. Toner's with the ball. Long ball forward, and there's O'Hanlon again. She's such an active player. Oh, okay, well done. Owen does well to intercept that one.
Yeah, nicely read by Kilala Owen. She's really liked on him.
Very, very liked. And she's not a tall girl, so she's got to make up for that with explosive movement from the floor. Baldwin finds it. A little smile from her. Leave it for Rikis to take and to convert. She does.
So PNG just needs to, you know, convert as many turnovers as they can, yeah, just to catch up. And that's just one of them.
Yeah, well, she did really well. But Jenna was actually shouting early. She wanted the immediate ball. It didn't come. And once it... Oh, that's another turnover. Big shame for the PNG. Okay. Toner moves it down to Jenna Bowman. Woods is right there, but she's not used. Picked up by Cooper. And then down to O'Hanlon again. That's out of play. It'll still be Northern Ireland's ball.
Contact on
that
the
is contact as yep. well. So Jenna has missed that one. And picked up nicely. So ball left for the defence. Owen to pick it up and move it forward. Need to move quite quickly through the... through the thirds, into the attacking third now, over the top. And again, it's very difficult to get round Tiata Baldwin. Rikis makes it. It's 2-2 in the fourth quarter. That means it's 34-41. Still hope here. Oh, that's a beautiful pass. Normally we expect her to be there with the shots on target, but that's a great pass from Baldwin. And Woods, was that an early break?
No, it's a contact. Overbreak.
Contact, wow, goodness. Now, this is really giving Papua New Guinea a lot to shout about, but again, another infringement and turnover.
Yeah, let down by another stopping.
O'Hanlon has come to the circle. A one-handed pass to Jenna. And Jenna Bowen makes it for 42. Still the 7-point difference from the third quarter. Oh, I don't quite know what that was. Was that contact again?
Yeah, that
maybe
was.
It was. Long ball, and Owen is right there, but it's out of play. Unlucky. Jesus, she's so fast.
She is. She came out of nowhere. Thought she got it cleanly, but just stepped over the sideline.
Again, some nice play. Touched. And again over the top, but Owen is in good shape. But that's a bad pass from Jenna Bowman. Again, PNG sniffing around, looking for some really, really important. And Gemma Gibney, right, I beg your pardon, is right there. Gibney does well.
Well, that was an easy intercept for her.
Yeah, Cooper is right there. And Woods infringes again with the ball. Oh, goodness. PNG, ever hopeful here. As long as they can stop the attacks, they can build up the points. There's Rikis, who gets a free shot at this one. Rikis is right there. This is for 36. This will come back within 6 points. There you go. Northern Ireland under threat here with less than 10 minutes left in the match. It was a much, much easier match for them in the last night's round robin, but here Jenna can really put a very important spin here, because at 4-4 in the fourth quarter they can survive with that. Oh, Toner was absolutely easy on that.
It almost looked like the pass was
unbelievable. Well, another one.
Knife you red.
I tell you, it's all about the intercepts at the moment. Quality play, we're not seeing so much of it, but intercept. Woods is penalised for that contact. 43-36. Baldwin makes it. She's got it there, and it will be another opportunity. Rikis will take it. There's Joan Yanni, who's been very, very efficient underneath the circle. Rikis is in for 37. Again, they're sniping at that lead. Good passes there, though. Jenna tries to find some space. She doesn't make it. Now she does. Okay, Woods then drops it inside for the bounce pass. Okay, off the rim and still in. 44-37. 8 minutes just under left in the match. This is the final match of the Mission Foods Nations Cup. It's a long ball, and while Rikis did really well there, Toner was put down on her bottom. And Baldwin gets it in for 38. Woods is rushing it. I think we need to rest early. Yeah, just control it. I know you. I hear what you're going to say. Go on. Go on, tell me.
Yeah, I think it's just maybe the style that, you know, you just want to keep the intensity high and just wear down your opponents.
Oh, my goodness. It's too easy for Papua New Guinea to recover from that. Jenna will not be happy with that play because it's a crucial play. They should have got it, Northern Ireland. 7 minutes left in the match. And Papua New Guinea putting on a really good show, much better than we hoped or we'd expected. But that's a Gibney push away. It's gone out. Gibney does a good job again, and that is a big relief for Northern Ireland.
Yeah, that might be an important rebound.
Definitely. Again, it was almost picked up. Woods does well. Just turns her body. Picks up the ball. There's an O'Hanlon special again. She really loved. She will shoot this, surely. She will. And oh, misses it. But Jenna's right there. Bowman bails her out. Oh, and another miss. That is going to be Papua New Guinea once more. It's getting a bit tense here. Certainly, there may well be an element of fitness here. If it's not physical fitness, it's mental fitness as well, because there's a lot of nerves. Oh, my goodness, that was unbelievable. You can't expect that to be picked up. Now, wing attack, was that Jacklyn Lahari?
I think that was wing defence, Shanna Dringo, a rush of blood.
Wing attack or defender, we couldn't quite see it. Well done again. Picked up. O'Hanlon is moving on down that right line. O'Hanlon picks it up again into Drayne. Woods is calling for it, gets it. Look at the way O'Hanlon comes across. She goes for the shot and makes it. My goodness me, she's everywhere. She is actually a bit of a Harry Potter, I think. She's got the magic touch everywhere.
Yes, she does.
Fabulous, and now a turnover, and that's so important with just over 5 minutes left. That really will probably settle down the nerves of Northern Ireland. They can come through strongly again. The shot is good. It's a beauty from O'Hanlon again. The girl from Newry has got another good position. Jenna this time will take it. And they've established another good position at 47-38. And that chance that was developing for Papua New Guinea is just evaporating away.
Yeah, that was three quick goals by Northern Ireland.
Yeah. And it means that they have taken. Oh, look at the Gibney again. It's over. Woods doesn't take it, but Drayne does. Drayne moves it forward. Jenna's finding space. O'Hanlon is right there. She's barged. It won't make a scrap of difference. O'Hanlon will take. Well, in fact, she's leaving it for Jenna. Opportunity for the goal shooter to make it there. Well, she'll get another one. Owen gets a bit too close. Jenna makes it. It's 48-38. And suddenly, the panic has evaporated. That is going to be, well, was that an injury? Maybe a medical or maybe a tactical? Well, whatever. It's going to be a timeout of 2 minutes. And with 4 minutes and 16 seconds left, I tell you, there was a moment there where there was a slight element of panic for Northern Ireland. but Papua New Guinea took their foot off the accelerator and allowed them back in. It's interesting, isn't it? The psychology of the game.
It is, and it swings so dramatically from one side to the other.
There's a smile on Julie Kimber's face there. You can just see it. Behind is the action there, Jenna, once again. She's actually done well, kept her position well. Although Kyla, her sister, started out so well, I tell you what, the replacement of having O'Hanlon in there, she's not let her team down at all. The great thing about O'Hanlon at goal attack is she's everywhere on the court. She is not just the feeder, she's the provider, she's the actual, she can intercept as well. It's amazing, I tell you what, she's impressed me from the first time I saw her.
Yeah, she's a really reliable and calm hit out there, so, you know, to play goal attack.
And she is right in the middle, goal attack there. Michelle Drayne, circle feet, did I see 20 there against her name? Wow.
That's a really impressive stat, because, you know, that's what you want to do, hit the circle edge, and then that's the easiest to feed.
Well, she wasn't the original centre either. That was for O'Hanlon, so, wow. Okay, we are ready to roll. With just 4 minutes, 16 seconds left in this Nations Cup 2015 competition. Over the top, and again, it's an Owen big pickup.
Oh, it's an easy one for Kilala. Her elevation is just fantastic.
Yep. Back again, and they've got to be quicker to move this. And again, some contact. Julie Kimber was telling me she loves my description of the hipping. It doesn't actually exist, I said, but it will do in time.
Yeah, we use it enough.
No, it's actually my description of the way in which the umpire holds herself. So she has got this big hip out, explaining that there has been contact. Anyway, Rikis is in for one, and that's 39-48. And Mavara is back in the centre again. Northern Ireland have to keep the concentration. She has not stopped. She's an absolute human dynamo. Look at that! Toner! It's a beautiful pass! What a fabulous pass! What a finish there for Jenna Bowman! That is Northern Ireland special. Not only do they rob where it counts, Toner was absolutely in a perfect position. Eyes wide open, saw the opportunity. O'Hanlon had a chance, didn't make it. It's picked up there by Wellington, but Drayne again takes the replay. But look at that from Owen. Unbelievable play. They are putting on a show for us here. Great intercepts.
They are.
49-39.
It's almost a, if you can do it, I can do
it
too.
It really is. Well, there's no quarter given or expected. A little bit of a contact there. Grabbing the ball out of the grasp, and here's Mavara once more. Mavara is there with the wing defender. That is Neves Cooper, and now it's with Woods. Here's Rikis, and she makes it for 40. We've got 2 minutes and 19 seconds left in the match. Northern Ireland, I think, will be home, but that's another brilliant pass. Beautiful play, and Baldwin will make this one. She has a 41, but now Woods is at the center. O'Hanlon again, working with Drayne well, and they, between them, have got the chance. Up it goes, in it goes, and another brilliant point for 50 for Northern Ireland. Come on, tell me her stats, can you, Pearline? I haven't had a look at them yet. Gibney is right there.
Ooh, that was a big one.
It was, and I saw Baldwin pointing at what she thought was an infringement prior to that, but it still will come back. The time off has been signaled, but Gemma Gibney, the captain, will take the ball, and they're asking, holding. It's still not going to be in play. It's gone the length of the court almost, well, two-thirds of the court. Gemma Gibney is asking for a towel to take away the sweat.
Yes, the dreaded sweat.
The dreaded sweat. Well, it is. I mean, in all sincerity, it is a dangerous thing, especially when you're going at these speeds. Toner did the job, taking the clear up. Cooper to Woods. Toner is there again to pick it up on the right flank, and then immediately comes O'Hanlon, who is really, look at her again, how does she do that? Unbelievable, unbelievable. She is definitely my heroine. I don't know what my wife would say. She thinks I'm talking a little bit too much about her, but I have to say, she has been fabulous.
She has been. She's such a good athlete, and then she's just been everywhere on court.
Well, if she's not the girl of the Northern Ireland team, we're going to make some presentations after. I'll be really amazed. Oh, some stepping there. We're less than 1 minute left in this match. 51-41. Northern Ireland can win it by the same margin as they won last night's game. This is very, very impressive by them to. They were under pressure a little bit. It's gone a little bit in swings and roundabouts, but the wing attack here, the clock is still going. Gemma picks it up. Here we have, okay, 52. Okay, the ball actually will go back immediately, and Mavara looks up at the clock a bit anxiously. 23 seconds left. They won't want to give this one up. No, they will have given it up. It comes back to Northern Ireland. They've got 16 seconds. Come on, look at it, Gemma. Long ball. Woods picks it up. O'Hanlon was there, but that is Cooper. O'Hanlon misses it, and that will be out of play. And that'll be the end of the match, I'm sure. 2-1-0. Northern Ireland are champions of the Nations Cup in Singapore. It's been a fabulous week for them. They have played six matches. They've won six matches. And it has been a really, really entertaining week of great netball. No doubt at all about that. And look at this. This is netball at its best. All the girls going, hugging each other and saying, yep, in the spirit of the sport, we congratulate each other. We were the best two teams on the week, or in the week. Northern Ireland have come up with a really, really impressive, and saying thank you to their crowd as well. Their supporters have been superb. 52-41 was the overall score, and there's no doubt at all, they were definitely worthy champions. They won it in 2009, and that means that Gemma Gibney has won it twice herself, because she was here, the captain, the 28-year-old, was there, and making again applause to their coach and to the crowd. Much appreciated. The Northern Ireland team, very, very popular here in Singapore. Danadial, well, I tell you, they sang "Oh Danny Boy." Well, that was earlier in the national anthems, and of course, joining together there in big celebration. It was a fabulous performance, wasn't it, Berlin?
It was.
The replay of the whole match here, the highlights of the whole package. There was Sarah Montgomery, she didn't even play in this match. But we'll have a look. Particularly, Kyla started out really well, although she was feeling unwell, according to her coach. Just look at this. I tell you, they were very, very much on the mark. And that one, unbelievable off-balance performance there. The crowd, supporters really loving that off the posts, and that still counts for Baldwin. They played well, did Papua New Guinea, in patches. They certainly came through strongly in the second and third quarters. And O'Hanlon there with that feed and that off balance shot again by Kyla. It was all very, very impressive. It's been a really good tournament. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have bringing it to you. We've had streaming throughout the week on YouTube, and of course now around the world feed. It's a great pleasure bringing the best of the Nations Cup netball to you. Jenna once again underneath. The Bowman sisters have done really, really well. Congratulations all round. They were the best team of the week, and certainly deserved it. We'll get the now Papua New Guinea, Northern Ireland score there for the, look at that, 89 in the overall full-time stats, 89%, 61% for Northern Ireland. But look at the difference in the attempts. Absolutely fantastic. Very, very impressive. It's going to be, in a while, we'll get the interview, and I've just been informed that, well, I mentioned it before, my heroine of the match and of the week, in fact, she's been non-stop dynamo. Certainly the battery operators should be looking at using her as one of their ambassadors, because she has been non-stop fabulous. Caroline O'Hanlon, I got a feeling, is there for the interview with Cheryl.
Hi Caroline, congratulations on the win. How do you feel?
We're absolutely delighted. We had a few bumps over the last day or two, and we're just delighted to get over the line today. It was a lot of pressure on us, having won all our games today. We knew Papua New Guinea were very strong. They started really well yesterday, and we knew they were going to start like that again today, and had other players coming in that they didn't have yesterday. So we were a wee bit nervous coming into the game, but we were well prepared, and we're delighted to get the win.
You guys have had an amazing week this week. What is your thoughts on your team's performance?
We're just delighted. It's a great tournament. We've been here before, and we've learned lots from it every time that we've been here. So we're just delighted to have won, I suppose.
All right, congratulations and thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
Well, again, Caroline O'Hanlon, she was everywhere on the court, deserved all the plaudits she got, and certainly deserves the ability to be calling herself champion now of this Nations Cup. It's become a very prestigious event over the years. 10 years now, Pearline Chan is with me, and we've enjoyed that match, haven't we?
Oh, we definitely have. You know, it's a pity about the first quarter, but other than the first quarter, all three quarters were really competitive, and PNG should be very proud of their efforts.
The crowd certainly during the week have been coming, really, really enjoying not just the quality of the play, but the way in which they can get close to the players as well. There's the trophy, and in just a while it will be presented to the captain of Northern Ireland. We've got some other presentations to be making. Meanwhile, Jessica Tan, I know the president of the Netball Singapore, will be making those presentations as the teams will be marching in. But in the meantime, of course, we might have just a little bit of a break as just look around the crowd. I know that there will be some interviews also. And I can see now Gemma Gibney coming over as well. She just walked in front of the camera and she will be interviewed. So I will just take a short break until there's some action with the presentation.